including this man, Michael Weiss from the United States. Two-time bronze medalist at the World Championships. He was seventh in both Nagano and Salt Lake City. And he has been felled by the flu this week. What's he got left?
Well, he showed in the short program yesterday that he had enough to get through that with a reasonable degree of performance, but he will now go from a 2.5-minute program to a 4.5-minute program. We'll have to see.
A very patriotic program.
Johnny comes marching home.
He doesn't have great technique on his triple axel, and it tends to give him problems. Oh, he's on a lean and not a great landing, and he couldn't get the second jump in.
Important to note that that will be counted as one of his combinations. He did a triple axel, single toe loop, so that one opportunity to score additional points with this combination, he's only got one other left.
Michael is the lone American in this Grand Prix final. Tim Gable having to withdraw because of skate problems. Michael coming from a very athletic family. His father, an Olympian back in 1964. His mother, a national gymnastics champion. It's a good pedigree.
He needs this combination. Triple flip, triple toe. He pulls it off.
Looked like the landing of the second jump might have been two-footed. Very rough landing on the triple loop jump. Wally jump into a triple axel. Right side dropped terribly, preventing him from landing that jump.
Well, he was determined to skate despite the flu, and we'll see what kind of endurance he has here in the late stages.
He's really struggling throughout this entire program. And this has to be frustrating for Michael because he's abandoned the quad in his quest to skate a cleaner program, but even the easier triple jumps are proving to be elusive out here today. Another fall in the triple jump.
point where a skater just sort of wants to get off.
But this also really draws to the forefront the importance of maybe what a good decision Jeff Buttle made by not skating. He knew he didn't have the strength. Michael came out here thinking he had it. Now he's got a very poor skate in his suitcase, so to speak, and you have to carry that through to your next competition knowing my last time out was not very pretty. Jeff Buttle at least goes home not having skated at all, disappointed that he didn't hit the ice, but no ugly performance baggage to go along with it.
Well, he's done. Michael Weiss of the United States. A gritty effort.
Well, full points for making the attempt, but you really have to look at where you're at, where you're going to skate. And in this situation, if he'd been this ill, knowing that he was going to skate at altitude, tough call.
And the U.S. Championships are just around the corner in January.
And this will not help him in his quest to get his national title back.
Look at the lean this jump is on. This thing was leaning before it even left the ice.
He just wants it over.
So encouraging applause from the crowd, support from his choreographer and wife, Lisa Thornton Weiss. And he looks like he's in a little difficulty after that 4.5 minute program. Third after the short program.
The technical score for this performance was.
And Weiss is hurting as he gets his score for the free skate. A total of 125.02. That's the best free skate of the day. Combine that with his score from the short program, 73.33. He has a total of 198.35. So temporarily in the lead, but Michael Weiss guarantees himself at least a bronze medal here in Colorado Springs. Still ahead, Emmanuel Sandu of Canada in second place after the short program and within striking distance of the gold.